Our next question is from Beck. It has been mentioned that there is an edge between aerobic and anaerobic soils. How would you take advantage of such a subterranean edge? Are there other edges in our soils and under our feet we might take advantage of? I'm stood in a dam that's leaking. It's one of our major lower dams, surprisingly. And we're gonna have to seal it. And we're working on that in the future. And it's gonna be a an earthworks course specialized in sealing a dam. We're gonna change these features. So I've just got this in the background to show you it doesn't always go to plan. It doesn't always work the way you want it to. And we've obviously got soil here that's leaking through to our river flat over towards the creek. But we're gonna sort that out. But normally you'd be gauging here that the spillway height up where the long grass is would be inundated with water and anaerobic, and that would go into the land a certain amount around the back of the dam here. Now anaerobic conditions create acidity, and then you can plant crops that like that acidity or trees that don't mind waterlogged roots. Now then you have the opposite. You have plants like avocados that need at least 4 feet of well-drained soil. And even then, if they're waterlogged under the 4 feet, once their roots get down into that wet anaerobic soil, they usually die off with a fungus called Phytophthora. So we need to mound up around this if we want to grow avocados on the edge of this dam. But we can take advantage of plants that like the anaerobic conditions, like blueberries. Plant trees like willows love their feet in water. They don't like to be dried out. But you're not gonna grow figs and pomegranates and olives next to water that anaerobic soil because they like dry conditions. So what it does is it allows you to gauge the diversity of species that like anaerobic or aerobic conditions and the depth of soil relationship to the size of the tree and the depth of the roots. So you can adjust all these things a little bit. Water coming up to a certain height is obviously going to create saturation. And you may have high water table. So it might not be a dam that's creating anaerobic soil. It might be the very fact that you're in lowlands with high water table and there's only so much soil naturally. You might have to then build up extra depths of soil to get an aerobic soil. In a lot of landscapes, it's easy to make soil more aerobic. You just got to make a pile and it drains off without much shape to it at all. But to actually create more anaerobic soil, you've got to actually trap it on contour and soak it in slowly and trap more and more soil. So what you're going to find is as you do good water harvesting techniques and you get leak points coming out, you're recharging spring lines, those spring lines that are continuously soaking are more anaerobic. So you're going to have lines of anaerobic conditions. So you're going to be able to vary the diversity in favor of both directions. And that makes a system more stable.